Is it possible to create a journal only from junk?
Yes!
And today I'll show you how.
You can take this video as an inspiration or as a step-by-step tutorial,
as you like.
Hi everyone, I'm Francesca from Junk Journal Joy.
And today I'll share with you how to create this journal.
First, I'm going to do a quick flip through to give you an idea of the final result. Despite this journal is made out of junk, it's full of memories because it's made with a lot of things that bring me emotion and feelings and joy. Like simple things, like a discover that is made with my favorite apples packaging. The butterfly with a special meaning to me, because my name is Francesca and Francesca means freedom, like a butterfly. This is a happy mail from Laura to the other side of the world. This is a beautiful bag from a beautiful, beautiful shop in Treviso of vintage things, candles, something like that. Very, very beautiful. This journal is special to me because it tells my story of 1 year in my life in Treviso in Italy. I'm moving soon, so this journal will be a beautiful memory keeper of this year. In fact, it's made only with junk that I collected this year in Treviso. This is a gifted calendar with the theme of recycling. This is a postcard from UK. A brown bag from an Etsy shop. This is a cereal plastic packaging. This pink envelope was the packaging of the photos that I took in Venice near Treviso, and so it's very, very special to me. This is a mail penalty. It's a memory because it was the last time that I saw my hometown, that is Mantova, also in Italy. These are packaging from my favorite tea and my favorite chocolate. This is the mail from an order by Postal Love, and it is a beautiful, beautiful mail with Belgium post stamp. And the last but not least, my favorite packaging of tortelli alla mantovana from Mantova, that is my own city. I also created for you this instruction sheet that is available with the newsletter. You can find the link in the description box of this video. This is the material list of things that you need to create this journal. So you need a scissor, a ruler, glue, washi tape and masking tape, a stapler, cotton, optional sewing machine, and an embossing cutting machine, totally optional. So, step one to create a true junk journal.
collect junk.
I encourage you to collect junk with a special meaning to you. Something connected with an event, a mail from a friend, packaging from a gift.
So your journal will be special and unique, very personal. It will tell your story and your journey. It will be an expression of yourself.
Step 2, divide this junk in 3 groups. Neutrals, color palette and to cover.
The first group of junk is made by color neutrals, so like white, grey, black and brown. I have bags, junk mail, packaging, happy mails. And also plastic from packaging. The second group is formed by trash with the color palette that you choose. So for me, for example, is green and pink. This packaging is an exception because it has a photo of my town, that is Mantua. Sometimes the beauty of collecting junk is the memory connected. And sometimes it's just beautiful, like this pink packaging. Very, very beautiful.
And usually the most beautiful packaging are from small business, so to speak.
And sometimes it's beautiful and meaningful, like this calendar gifted to me, that is a calendar with the recycling theme.
These are broken jewelry. And these are ribbons from gift and cakes.
The third group is made by things that I want to cover because the colors are too much and they are not the color of my color palette. But this is a personal preference. You can do what you want. You can absolutely create your journal like a rainbow journal. That is also great. So I'll cover with packaging filler and book pages. Step 3, cut the excess. The first thing that I wanted to do with every group is to cut the excess. You can use a scissors, ruler or a cutter.
Step 4, cover what you want to cover. These can be tags or pages. I'll make one just to show you an example. I made a few tags, so you can have some examples. And now I'll create a page with the same exact method. Step 5, create the pages. I have some washi tape, masking tape, cotton to connect the pages. For the fabric, I'll use the glue flash bond or fabric tack, so the sewing machine is totally optional. My advice is to create one group of pages at a time. I'm choosing pages randomly from every group created. In this case, don't think too much, just do. You can always adjust later if you don't like the result. So for example, for the first two, I'll connect with the sewing machine, but you can also create pages, group of pages with the hinge method. That is the method that I show you in this moment. You can just connect the pages with masking tape. You can also use washi tape to embellish the masking tape. For example, this washi tape is from Amity Bloom. I will link her Etsy shop down below. and in this case I'm using the saving machine only to embellish. I'm using a pink neon thread because it's fun and it reminds me the early 90s. That is the best time ever for me. For the second group of pages, I will use also coffee stain cotton. This is a towel. I'm using these cotton inches, one to reinforce the binding and two to cover the masking tape. The inge method is inspired by Amity Bloom, so I will link her channel below. Now I am embellishing the inge with the saving machine. It's totally optional. This will create the illusion that the binding is made with the saving machine, but it's not. To add the fabric, I'm using flash bond, or you can use also fabric tack. That is a glue, a special glue for fabric. Continue to create these groups of pages until you are satisfied. There are no rules, but only suggestions. In this case, it's always optional, but I will use the sewing machine to reinforce the binding and to create the closure for the bags on the bottom of the pages. To connect the envelope, you can use also masking tape or washi tape in this case, but I use the sewing machine to create a strong connection. In this case, it works better because I'm using cereal packaging for the pages, and so it's a little bit difficult to stick something on this plastic. Step 6, create the covers, the front, the back, and final touches. For the front cover, I choose some elements to create a waterfall, from the smallest to the largest. And to connect all these elements, I will use the same method that I use for the other pages. This layered waterfall design is inspired once again by Emmett Bloom. These are plastic from yogurt packaging that we can use for the windows. This is an embossing machine from Sixis, and we can use it for emboss the plastic from packaging. And here is our window, and we can use the stapler to connect it. For the back, I'll use the same method, and I will use this beautiful mail with beautiful stamps and this packaging from tortelli alla zucca. To add the final touch on the cover, I will use again my embossing machine, but this time to cut some funny shapes. I will use I don't know what it is, maybe aluminum from packaging, and cardboard from my trash. I'm using the stapler to add the butterfly on the cover. And it's done! Seven, the binding. For the binding, the method is the same used for creating the pages. So you will use washi tape, cotton inches, masking tape, and we have to connect the group of pages to another, one group at a time. Like before, you can use whatever you want, but for me the best method is use masking tape to hold everything in place, and then cotton stripes to add with FabriTac or flash bond glue. In this case, like before, I'm using the sewing machine only to embellish the stripes, but it is optional. This gives an illusion of a binding made with the sewing machine, and it's beautiful, but it's optional. You can also use only washi tape and masking tape, but in this case add some glue to make the connection stronger. To embellish the spine, I will use some ribbons from cakes and gifts, and a broken jewelry. This from an old clothes of mine. Here I'm failing because I broke it, so I'll try it again. I'm doing a simple knot. And now just add this ribbon in the center of your journal with a knot. I hope you enjoyed this video. Thank you so much for watching. I'm so curious about your thoughts, so leave me a comment below and have a lovely day.